And thank you, all of you, for being here today, which we hope for all of us will be a historic gathering. 3 years ago, and everything always has a story, so I'll tell you the story of this. 3 years ago, a mutual friend arranged a reintroduction to Julian Robertson at his office at Tiger Management. And fortunately for him, Julian had been seated next to me 30 years earlier at a dinner, shortly after Susan Komen was founded. My late husband, Norman Brinker, was appalled that I had talked Julian's ear off about our new organization. But he was polite and interested in hearing about the promise I had made to my sister Susie to rid the world of breast cancer. And our paths diverged later that evening. And in the years that followed, Susan G. Komen became the world's largest private funder of breast cancer research. And Julian and his amazing wife, Josie, became some of our nation's most celebrated philanthropists. Years later, Josie was diagnosed with breast cancer, and she lived and fought for many years, thanks to the superb care she received at Memorial Sloan Kettering. After her death in 2010, Julian made his own commitment to help find a cure, to fund important work, and to look to new horizons. And for the past 5 years, he has given his time, money, intellect, and energy to the mission. The Josie Robertson Surgery Center at Memorial Sloan Kettering is just one example. This amazing facility will soon be providing specialized care to patients needing outpatient treatments. It's a wonderful memorial to Josie and a testimony to the commitment of their family, and I would encourage all of you to go walk through it and see it after December, after it opens. Well, the work of the Robertson Foundation is also reflective of the family's commitment to improving health care, with grants to the Cancer Research Institute, the New York Stem Cell Foundation, and the New York Academy of Sciences, to name just a few. Last fall, Julian invited me and his two wonderful sisters to join him at Oxford University, where his name had been placed in perpetuity on the Clarendon Arch. It was an incredible moment, but in Julian's mind, it ran a distant second to another moment of that trip, a visit to the medical school and a meeting with Sir John Bell, a professor of medicine. He talked about the progress that Oxford has made in using large data sets within the British NHS to improve their own research and treatments. And in their conversation, they began to talk about how to do that more broadly. Over the past decade, we've made so many advancements in fields like molecular oncology and genomics. We're now aware that by defining disease more precisely, we can concentrate resources and optimize outcomes through matching interventions with the patients most likely to benefit. To maximize these benefits, however, we need to rely on multiple sets of diverse data from large numbers of individuals. Healthcare is rich in data: patients' notes, biochemical and physiological data, monitoring data, therapeutic response data, genomic data, and pathological data. But we have been slow to extract knowledge from these sets. The conjunction of digital healthcare, now new approaches to generating data from high throughput tools such as genomics, improvements in IT, and new analytical capabilities are now allowing us to use all of this information to generate new insights into this disease and how best to treat it. In breast cancer, this is having a dramatic effect on how we manage disease, how we develop new therapies, and how we educate patients and create hope as they go through their journey forward. And as precision medicine takes hold, the most important engine for change will come from acquiring, storing, and analyzing these large data sets. So in that meeting between Julian and Professor Bell, the idea for this meeting was born, and thanks to the Robertson Foundation's philanthropy, we will all learn more about these exciting prospects in the coming days and years ahead. I'm so honored that the esteemed president and CEO of the Robertson Foundation, Dr. John Hood, specifically asked for Susan G. Komen to help organize this meeting. We've always worked to be on the cutting edge of science and culture, utilizing every tool available. And so today is no exception. We are very, very excited to be here. We also welcome and thank the leaders of the Robertson Foundation, Julia Nador. Thank you, Julia, for being here. Ruth Brenner, all the people in your foundation who work so hard to make this meeting happen. We thank you enormously. We also want to thank and give much gratitude to Dr. George Sledge and Dr. Eric Weiner, the heads of our scientific advisory board, and all of the members who've worked to make this so very, very successful. Mark Tessier-Levine and Rockefeller University for making room for us, Joanne Nichols, and to Eric Rosenthal for producing the white paper that will result from this meeting. And we also want to thank Dr. Judith Salerno, our CEO, and all of the fine staff at Susan G. Komen who've done such a good job pulling this together the last 6 months. But thank you also to all of you, the prolific scientists, experts, and researchers who have joined us in the midst of the busiest season of the year to share information and build new models. On behalf of breast cancer survivors like me, thank you for the time and interest that you're giving to the task and to the hope you will provide us with so many more.